So the first thing we're going to show you is installing a VPN service using an anonymous gift card. So going to a store, purchasing a gift card, and running through that. So basically, this is just going to take you through it, and Jack and I will go kind of back and forth on these slides. But we're loading incognito window, which we didn't talk about before. It's basically making sure that you're not caching anything locally on the machine, cookies, etc. So as you go to these sites, it's not keeping that information. We're going to go to privateinternetaccess.com. There's tons of VPN tools out there. This is just one that I know we both like.
Although one of the reasons we picked it, there's a website called Torrent Freak, which lists kind of the top VPN providers. One thing we do like about Private Internet Access, you've got to understand where the company's based and what their country laws are. The U.S. does not have a retention policy when it comes to VPN products.
Right.
So we like PIA. They are out of the U.S. They do not have a retention policy, so they won't hold any data whatsoever.
Right.
So understanding kind of what they're bound to, like U.K., I used to use Hide My Ass VPN. That's out of the U.K. Don't use that one, because GCHQ is a thing and they do have data retention rights that they have to adhere to.
So here's an important part to keep in mind. This is that paying with an anonymous branded gift card. One of the things you can do is go to a store, get a gift card for $50, and they have literally hundreds, we're gonna scroll through them real quick, of different gift cards that you can take, turn in, and purchase. That means you're not listed, you're not connected to your credit card. You're not connected to your home address. You're not connected to all these pieces because you went and took cash, traded it for another mechanism, and then use that to purchase your VPN service. It's making one more level, one more obstacle for people trying to figure out who you are and what you're doing. So we're gonna make that purchase now, and blur this out because I wanna make sure that that's the data that's protected here.
Because security.
Yeah, security's good. So we're gonna enter in the card number data off that gift card. It's gonna go in, it's gonna check the balance because they wanna make sure that it's an actual gift card. And basically we're paying $50 for 366 days of VPN access. I'm gonna put in an email address that was created for the presentation, James Madison fourthamendmentisaservice.com. And basically they'll email you a set of credentials. So you're probably saying to yourself, but wait a minute, they're gonna email me credentials. That sounds pretty easy to trace. We're gonna show you in a video in a few minutes here, 10-minute basically burner email accounts so you can get your credentials.
I prefer Gorilla Mail because you can get the email address at sharklasers.com.
Who doesn't like sharks with lasers?
Exactly.
That's right. So now we're going into Gmail. This is gonna cut for a second here. So basically your username and password, and then you go back to the site. And little pro tip, I actually ran into this making the video. They will send you a link for the actual installer. Don't use the link in the email. They haven't updated it yet. Actually go to the page and download the client. I spent about 20 minutes beating my head against the wall on that. So pro tip from me to you. So basically you'll download the installer. We're obviously doing this on a Mac. And what we want to show you here is really what you should be getting from these videos as we run through them, is these are being done in real time. This is how quickly you can go from I'm just on the internet, and notice, you may have noticed at the top of these things, there's an IP address that's blurred. They show you what your externally facing IP address is. They know, because that's how networking works. They know where you're coming from. Once we get this installed, we'll actually select a different location. In the video, you'll see we actually select London. So whoever is seeing us connect to their website or their VPN know our termination point is London. I am not in London. I'd like to be in London, but I'm not in London. So we'll take those credentials and we add them in to the client that was just installed. And it takes a couple seconds here, but then in a few minutes, or not minutes, a few seconds, you'll see the actual dropdowns here for the selections. So we'll paste those credentials in. And like I said, what I like about these videos is that they are real time. This isn't, all right, I'm gonna go home, it's gonna take me 20 minutes of reading something, and then I gotta go get it installed, et cetera. You go from no VPN to VPN in about 5 minutes.
Zero to hero.
So here we are. Notice all these connection types. We can come from Florida, Texas, Chicago, Montreal, Sydney. Then we can go more, Denmark, Finland, Switzerland, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So these are all ways that you can say, all right, I want this traffic to look like it's an originating from a different point. And you'll notice here I call out the IP address. I'm gonna go connect to London. And right now I'm on Bright House Networks. Many of us probably have Bright House Networks. And you'll see the little robot connect. And once the little robot connects, we'll refresh the page. And hoocha, 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 lobster.
Green robot good, red robot means it's disconnected, gray robot means you don't have PIA turned on.
So. And there we go. So now we're at Chupa or Chopa, I can't say that right, LLC, and the IP address is out of London. Our data is now encapsulated and protected, and it looks like we're sitting maybe on the River Thames surfing the internet. And that's it. That's the VPN service.